Friends, I welcome you all in my kitchen at healthykadai. Today we are making simple and sweet eggless cinnamon cookies. These cookies are simply irresistible. We are not using any refined ingredients in it, no refined flour, no refined sugar, and the best part is that you can make these cookies without using oven. So let's get started. Thank you so much for watching our videos. Please continue to like our video, share our video with your friends and family, and most importantly, don't forget to subscribe to healthykadai if you're new to our channel. We will sieve 125 grams or 1 cup of whole wheat flour or atta. Into this we'll add a pinch of baking powder, and then we'll sieve both our ingredients. We'll keep it aside. After that we need to cream butter and sugar together. For this I'm using 1/2 cup or 80 grams of butter. The butter should be at room temperature. Instead of butter, one can even use desi ghee to prepare these biscuits. Into butter we'll add 1/2 cup or equal quantity of sugar. Here I'm using powdered brown sugar. And now we need to cream both butter and sugar together. I'm using a spatula to cream this mixture, however one can even use electric beater, that will fasten up the process. To cream the butter it will easily take 5 to 10 minutes. We need to cream it until this mixture becomes light and fluffy. You can have a look at it. The mixture is absolutely light and fluffy. Into this, for the flavor, we'll add 1 teaspoon of vanilla essence. Vanilla essence is completely optional. We'll mix it together. And our butter and sugar creamed mixture is ready. After creaming, we'll add dry ingredients in it. But before adding, we'll add cinnamon powder in our flour mixture. Here, I've added 1/2 teaspoon of cinnamon powder. You can increase the quantity of cinnamon powder as per your taste. We'll mix it together with flour. You can also sieve cinnamon along with the flour at the initial stage as well. And then we'll gradually add dry ingredients in the creamed mixture. Here goes the rest of the quantity. After that, we need to knead a nice dough. Work with a very light hand. You will feel that the mixture is very crumbly. So in order to hold the mixture together, we'll add 1 to 2 tablespoons of milk in it so that we are able to knead a dough. However, do not add milk in one go. Just add the required quantity of milk, and my bowl is clean. Our dough is ready. Let's start to prepare our biscuit. We need to roll out the dough. For this, sprinkle dry flour on a flat platform and also dust the rolling pin with the dry flour. And with a very light hand, we need to roll out the dough. Because we have used whole wheat flour to prepare this biscuit mixture, so there will be cracks on it. But you'll be able to roll out it. Just flatten it up as much as possible. This is approximately 1/2 centimeter thickness. And then we'll neaten up the edges. I have cut it into this rectangular form. However, you can cut your cookies in any desired shape, be it circle, star, or any other shape. Here I'll be making rectangular biscuits, so we'll cut these into long rectangles. After cutting, using a fork, we'll prick each of these biscuits. Kids usually love this pricking process, so involve your kids during this stage. Once the biscuits are ready, we'll be baking them. I'll be baking these biscuits in a kadai. However, you can bake these biscuits in an oven or an air fryer. For baking the biscuits in a kadai, I am using this steel plate which I have lined it with parchment paper. Using a palette knife, we'll very carefully place all the biscuits in it. Keep little space in between two biscuits, and now let's bake it. For baking, I've already preheated the kadai with salt in it. We have also placed the stand at the center, and here goes our biscuits in it. We'll cover it with a big plate and we'll bake it on lowest flame. It will take approximately 30 to 40 minutes. However, we'll check the biscuits in between. It's been 20 minutes and you can see that the biscuits have started to bake from the bottom side. So we'll flip over the biscuits and we'll continue to bake it on lowest flame for another 10 to 15 minutes. Baking is done. I've baked all these biscuits in two batches. You can see that these cinnamon biscuits have come out so well. Very nicely baked biscuits. These biscuits taste very nice and these are healthy too because we have not used any refined ingredients in it. Just have a closer look at this biscuit. These biscuits are crunchy as well as crispy. As the festivities are around, you will truly enjoy the aroma of cinnamon in these biscuits. One can even bake these biscuits and gift it to your friends and family. They will also enjoy it. I have also prepared these few star-shaped biscuits for my son. So you can even pack these biscuits for your kids' lunchbox. They will also enjoy having these healthy cinnamon biscuits. So do try out the recipe and let me know how does it turn out for you. I'm sure you will really like the taste and flavor of these biscuits. I'll be waiting to hear back from you. So please write to us in the comment section below. If you liked watching our today's video, please do give us a thumbs up and don't forget to subscribe to Healthy Kadai for more such interesting recipes. Until our next video, happy cooking and stay healthy.